So I think after a few months, I've finally perfected my home workout regimen. Have you ever used empty wine bottles as weights?
110.
I just did 110 of those. Look, Congress is like the dentist. You know it's there and that you have to occasionally deal with it, but that doesn't make it pleasant. Except, well, Congress is suddenly more popular than it's been in more than a decade, according to new numbers from Gallup. By the way, no word on whether dentists are experiencing a similar polling renaissance. And for the record, I am no anti-dentite. I love you, dentists. Look at these pearly whitish teeth. Now, before members of Congress start popping bottles, rap reference, it's worth noting that their approval rating in Gallup's new data is just 31%, which means that a whole lot more people still disapprove of the job they're doing than approve of it. But there's no question that Congress's popularity has improved significantly since the start of 2020. Gallup polling from March of this year pegged congressional approval at just 22%. Now, while that number didn't match the record low of 9% approval for Congress back in late 2013, the January number was generally consistent with where Congress has found itself over the past 10 years, with a little more than one in five Americans thinking their federally elected officials are doing a good job. According to Gallup, by the way, the average congressional approval over the past decade? 17%. Not good. So, what's changed? Well, the coronavirus pandemic crippled the country and Congress reacted aggressively, that's what, passing a series of bills that pump money into the economy in hopes of keeping it afloat until stay-at-home orders and quarantine restrictions designed to stem the spread were deemed no longer necessary. Previous Gallup polls show how much Congress's image was helped by its reaction to the coronavirus pandemic. So in that March Gallup survey, nearly 6 in 10 Americans said they approved of the job Congress was doing to combat the virus. Now that number did dip slightly to 48% in April, but it was still way above Congress's usual job approval average. And look, I'm all about celebrating beyond average. Have you seen my jump shot? It's raining. Not really, it's a term. So what does this mean for Congress big picture? Quote, although Americans are still mostly negative toward Congress, their opinions of the institution now are the most positive they have been in over a decade, wrote Gallup's Jeffrey M. Jones, analyzing the Gallup data, adding, its work to address the coronavirus crisis has likely contributed to those higher ratings. Thanks, Jeff, that's what I said. Now, the approval has also helped across party lines, which is interesting. While almost 4 in 10 Democrats approve of how Congress is doing its job, 32% of independents and 24% of Republicans also say the same. And that accounts for at least an 8-point jump upward for all three partisan affiliations since the beginning of the year. So I take two big lessons from these numbers. One, people don't like Congress until they need it. Much like the dentist. Teeth pain. Over the past 2 decades, there's been a general erosion of the public's belief in the necessity of government to step in and solve problems. Remember, by the way, that Bill Clinton declared the era of big government over way back in his 1996 State of the Union speech. That was 24 years ago. Now, the only break in that general decline in wanting the government in your life is in the immediate aftermath of natural disasters or tragedies. Support for government rose in the wake of Hurricane Katrina and after the terrorist attacks of September 11, 2001, for instance. By the way, the highest Gallup has ever measured congressional approval was 84% in an October 2001 poll. So in short, we don't like the government in our business, except when we feel like we need something that we can't get or do ourselves. And then we want all the government help we can get. Okay, lesson number two. People like when Congress actually, you know, does stuff. The defining trait of the House and Senate over the past decade has been inaction fueled by partisan gridlock. Congress literally can't even do the little things because someone on the fringes of either party gums up the works. Congressional term, gums up the works. Well, the last 2 months have produced a whirlwind of activity by Congress. They are getting lots done and much of it on a bipartisan basis. Why, you ask? Go back to point one. Reality check time. If past is prologue, and it almost always is, the approval gains made by Congress will be relatively short-lived. Already, the prospects for another stimulus bill, this one aiding state and local governments, look less rosy as House Democrats and Senate Republicans can't seem to get on the same page about funding and who gets it. And at some point in the future, when this coronavirus pandemic finally passes, and it will, the same old deep partisan divisions that led to the stagnation in Congress seem very likely to reassert themselves. But for an institution that has spent most of the past decade looking jealously at the media's job approval rating, that's sarcasm, people, Congress is having a moment in the sun. Let's not dwell too long on how brief that moment is likely to be. And that is the point. We make new point episodes every Tuesday and Thursday. Be sure to check them all out.